In this lecture, we see the trap aided Ogieri combination, which is part second of the Ogieri combination. So in this lecture, we see trap aided Ogieri combination. This Ogieri combination may become significant at higher carrier concentration the trap aided Ogieri combination can be of two types. So let me draw these two types of Ogieri combination. Ogieri trap aided recombination. So first, this is minima of the conduction band, and if this is EV, we can make another diagram here. So this is EV, maximum of the valence band, and this is EC, minimum of the conduction band. So let's, our trap is here. So this is the state, energy state for trap. So in first type of Ogieri recombination, so this is first type of trap aided Ogieri combination, and this is second. So let me write about both of these processes. So in process A, a trapped electron makes a transition to the valence band by giving its energy to an electron in the conduction band. So in diagram A we can see that this electron from the trap goes to valence band, and this energy, which is the difference between the energy level of the trap and the maximum of the valence band. So now this electron will release this energy, and this energy is giving to this electron. So this, by taking this energy, this electron now will move from here to here. So in this way, let me write it as ET. This difference is ET. Here we can also write this difference. So now this electron is making transition to the valence band from the trap level, and this electron gives this energy to one of the electron in the conduction band, and by taking that energy, this electron will move upward in the conduction band. So this is first type of trap added Ogieri combination. So here the rate of this process let's assume it as RA can be written as RA, which is equal to TA P N T. We have NT represents the concentration of trapped electron and TA is the trapped OJ coefficient. And one important thing to notice that this process is become very important only in a very heavily doped n-type semiconductor with a very high concentration of traps below the Fermi level. So now let's come to the second process. That is shown in diagram B. So process B shows recombination involving two holes and one electron. Here the electron makes a transition to an unoccupied state or trap level in the band gap and giving its energy to a hole in the valence band. So in process B, two holes and one electron are involved. Here the electron makes a transition to an unoccupied trap level in the band gap and giving its energy to a hole in the valence band. So here we can see in first process we can see an electron is making a transition from trap level to the valence band. But here an electron is making transition from conduction band to the trap level, and this energy difference is given to another electron in the valence band, and by getting this energy this electron will move upward in the valence band. So this hole from here is now going to here. So in this way there are one this and one, there are two holes and one electron is involved. So this is type 2 of trap added OJ recombination. And similarly the rate of this process B can be written as RB, which is equal to TB PN PT where PT is the concentration of empty states in the trap layer, and TB is the respective trap OJ recombination, OJ coefficient, trap OJ coefficient. As I mentioned in earlier case. And this is also worth to note that this process may acquire importance in heavily doped p-type semiconductor with a large density of traps located above the Fermi level. So these are two types of trap added OJ recombination processes. Now in N-type semiconductor, the bulk lifetime, we can write it as tau p prime, is obtained as, so 1 by tau p prime, which is equal to 1 by tau p plus 1 by tau r प्लस वन बाई टाउ ए वेहर टाउ आर इज रेडिएटिव रिकॉम्बिनेशन लाइफ टाइम। टाउ ए इज द ओजे लाइफ टाइम and tau p is the Shockley Reed and Hall lifetime. So here in short we can see that the lifetime of a carrier in semiconductor can be written as the combination of radiative recombination, Auger recombination, and Shockley Reed and Hall recombination lifetime. So, in a similar way, we can write bulk lifetime tau n prime in a p-type semiconductor as वन बाई टाउ एन प्राइम विच इज इक्वल टू वन बाई टाउ पी प्लस वन बाई टाउ आर एंड प्लस वन बाई टाउ ए। सो ऑल दिस टाउ पी टाउ आर टाउ ए are having the same meaning as I discussed for above equation. So this is all about this trap added Auger recombination. And if we take a special case, now let's define this as equation number third. And we can write this as equation number second or two. Sorry, this one is 2, equation number 2, and above equation we can write as equation number 1. This is third and this is equation number 4th. So, if we take some special cases like In the case of silicon and germanium, the last two terms in equation 3 or 4th are negligibly small unless the carrier concentration is very high. So normally we can write tau p prime, which is equal to tau p, and we know it very well that silicon and germanium are indirect band gap semiconductors. So there is very minimum amount of radiative recombination. So, and we also know that in indirect band gap semiconductors there are only indirect recombination, which is Shockley, Reed and Hall recombination. So all these two terms are very small, or we can neglect these two terms in the case of indirect band gap semiconductor like silicon and germanium. So at lower doping or at small doping, the bulk lifetime for silicon and germanium is directly proportional to the Shockley, Hall and Reed recombination lifetime. So this is all about recombination processes. In this unit we have studied three types of recombination, that is radiative recombination, indirect radiative recombination is also known as direct recombination. Second one we have studied about indirect recombination, which is also known as Shockley, Reed and Hall recombination. And third, we have studied about OG recombination. And there are two types of OG recombinations. First one is direct band to band OG recombination. And the second one that we have studied today, which is known as trap added recombination. So we have covered all these recombination processes and all these generation processes. So this is all about these recombinations, and in next lecture we will study about the switching in electronic devices.